the eternity sign was something that took quite a while to work up.
You mean to convince people? No.
Yes. To convince people. Yeah. We actually, after we'd done the first bridge effect in 1996, mm-hmm. seven, which was actually our designer, Peter England, having a funny cigarette while sitting at the at the Opera House and looking at the bridge and going, I am smiling. And so, you know, up it went.
Wow.
We then had to think about, you know, bridge effects for the next few years. Yeah. And I had all of these Martin Sharp prints.
Of course, he was a big fan.
I'm a huge fan of his work.
Yeah.
In my office at the...
Was there.
Just on the
just
wall.
Just looking at you.
Yeah, and we had this... but funnily enough, we had this work experience guy. I don't know where he was from, some posh school. And, you know, the biggest problem with work experience people is getting them...
They're bored, right?
Yeah. Well, giving them something to do. Anyway, he became infatuated with eternity.
He didn't know the history.
No. And I just happened to have the old video, the VCR documentary on Arthur Stace.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I said, if you're interested, take it home and
read up.
Yeah, you know, read up on it. Anyway, that Friday afternoon when we had our usual wine o'clock, which is...
What time that start?
When we always got our best ideas.
Afternoon is 12:01 p.m.
Yeah, that's... And we were going, what are we going to do, you know, and this little kid goes, why don't you put eternity up on the bridge?
That's amazing.
Absolutely true. And I went,
who has no name?
Hold that thought. I've forgotten it. No.
and now he's the Prime Minister, the Scott Morrison, right? Yeah. Who would have thought?
Can he contact us, Chris? Is there a point?
Please.
Because I'm all fired up. I'm all fired up and lonesome. I got a chip on my shoulder. I'm acting just a little too tough.